Hi, my name is Elspeth van Paridom. By passport, I'm Dutch, but I mostly grew up in Belgium. And here we are in Beijing, living, working, doing stuff. I landed back in China after our little break on January 9th, 2020. Yeah. Timing. So, I will say this, when it all happened, I was in Shanghai, and during the outbreak, there was one thing that I'd never experienced before, and I know it's supposed to be embedded in society here, Confucianism, but there was unity. And it was very, very, very strong. There was a lot of empathy and unity, and that has lasted, that has been extended throughout 2021 even. This is not gonna sound very deep, but I'm very happy here. I found a job, I started 3 months ago, I met new people because I really came back to China to be back at the source of it all, and that paid off. So I'm a happy cookie here. I know, again, that's a very superficial thing, but for me, I think also, yeah, everything, we went back to normal pretty swiftly now, didn't we? I work for the state media, China International Publishing Group, more specifically, Beijing Zhoubao, Beijing Review. It's the only English print issued by the state media, weekly. I have a pet project, or a passion project, as I refer to it. It's called Temper, China Temper. And it's basically what I do, which is look at China through the angles of fashion and urban culture. China fashion publishing. That's what I'm gonna do. And I really started homing in on this whole China through fashion thing after I moved here in 2010. But not blogging or anything, but just looking at it more and more and more. And it turned more serious or into my niche or whatever you want to call it, I think in around 2015-16. Yeah. So the idea naturally developed. As superficial or trivial you may find fashion, what you decide to put on in the morning is a conversation you're having with the world. I'm not saying it's who you are, you know, it's not your perpetual state of being as to what you're wearing, but it is what you wanna, it is what you're telling the world that day. You know, if I walk out in a t-shirt and overalls, it's basically me saying, just leave me be, not in the best mood ever. I studied this thing, this country, so for me it was a natural step. After you finish studying that, you move to the country that you studied to work and to live. China has always given me opportunities. Whereas in the West, I'll be honest here, I went to New York, right, just for a bit. Everybody, oh, China through fashion, urban culture, that's so interesting, oh my God. But then, tumbleweeds. And I've been laughed out of the rooms. The only people who ever said, like, she's got a point. Here. What else do you want? What more could you want?